Hey dolls! So y'all have been asking me for a makeup tutorial, so that's what we're gonna do today. I'm gonna show you how to achieve this cotton candy dream makeup look. But before we get into it, I have to give a little shout out to today's video sponsor, which is, yeah, you probably guessed it, it's Dossier. Ugh, I love them so much. I love being able to work with them. The cool thing about how this works is you get a big perfume bottle delivered to your door in this cute little box like so, and then you get a little sample bottle. So the perfumes are about $30, and you receive the box just like this with a little pamphlet, basically explaining how the process works and the underlying notes and top notes of the scent itself, depending on which one you get. And what you do is you test out the small sample bottle. You get to keep this no matter what. But if you test it out and you're not really a fan of the scent, you can just not open the big bottle and seal up the box and send it right back for a full refund. So you can test perfumes without having to leave your home, which because of COVID, we don't like to necessarily go out for luxury purposes. It's more of a necessity thing. So maybe those of us who've been wanting to treat ourselves, maybe the holidays are coming up, you want to give a gift to someone, but you don't really want to go out in the big crowds and go shopping. Dossier is a wonderful, wonderful option. They are made in France. They are completely vegan and cruelty free. All of their scents are vegan and cruelty free, which is amazing. And they actually specialize in making dupes of big name designer brand perfumes, which, as you guys know, most of those aren't vegan or cruelty free. So the fact that they make dupes is super affordable for you guys, and it's a little bit better for some animals, if you know what I mean, if you're an animal lover like I am. And they also use clean ingredients as well, so that is wonderful. So the two scents that I have been dipping into and testing out a little bit recently are Floral 6, and this one has top notes of pear, orange blossom, bergamot, and then it has other notes of rhubarb, rose, amber, and it's kind of musky as well. This one is beautiful. I really like the scent of this one. It's very feminine. And then the other one that I have been testing lately is Fresh Floral 2, and this one is a very clean smell. I feel like it's very kind of oceany. It kind of gives like ocean, beachy, salty air vibes. So it's a little bit different than the other one, but it's still very unique and pretty in its own way. I can't remember the scents that these are both supposed to be dupes of, but if you go to their website and browse around a little bit, you can figure it out very easily. I also did a full video testing the designer brand name perfumes as well as Dossier to compare the two, and they were very similar. So if you want to watch that video, it's from quite a while ago, you can click here and check it out. But yeah, they were very, very, very similar. Check out Dossier. I will link them in the description box down below. Let's move on to the makeup tutorial, shall we? All right, hello. You are all zoomed up on me. I have already done my face, and I will link my foundation routine on the screen right here. So if you want to see how I get like a flawless base, that is where to go. I am not doing my eyebrows for obvious reasons. I have bangs and you barely see them anyway. So I haven't been doing them lately, so I'm not going to be doing them in this video. Also, I want to mention that I will be using some Jeffree Star Cosmetics products, and I know not everyone is a supporter of him. I just have something to say before we get into this, is that it doesn't matter if you no longer support something or someone. If you've already given your money to them, don't just throw it in the trash. Please do not be wasteful. Use your products that you paid for. Damage has already been done. You've already supported that person. There is no sense in just throwing this in a landfill and being completely wasteful with it. Use the products that you paid for, that you got your money's worth for, even if you no longer support the person, their concepts, their ideals, etc. So yes, I know a lot of you are off the Jeffree Star train, and that is fine. That is totally okay, trust me. But I am letting you know that some of the products in this video are going to be Jeffree Star Cosmetics. I'm not condoning necessarily going out and supporting him or anything of that matter. You can also find alternatives to these products. I just wanted to use one palette for my eye look instead of trying to dip into like three or four different ones, just out of convenience for the video. So that is why I'm dipping into the Jawbreaker palette for my eyeshadow. But yeah, anyway, let's get onto the video now. And today I am using the Jeffree Star Jawbreaker palette. I got this as a Christmas gift last year. All criticisms aside, his palettes are actually really good. So we're gonna use the pink, purple, and blue shades. So Bubblegum, Gumdrop, and Brain Freeze. So those are the three that I'm gonna dip into here. And I'm just gonna create a very simple gradient look on the top and on the bottom. And then I'm gonna do a little bit of a cut crease, which you guys pretty much have already seen the end result. So enough of me jabbing away. Let's go ahead and start applying the shadows. So I'm just gonna take a fluffy blending brush like so. These are dirty. Let's be real, not everyone cleans their makeup brushes in between applications. What I'll do though is I will take some rubbing alcohol and swirl it around on like an old washcloth or something, or paper towel, and sometimes there is staining left over. So as this looks dirty, most of it is just a stain. Okay, so dipping into Bubblegum, the pink shade, I'm just gonna go through and apply this. Get my bangs out of the way here. Should have pinned them back, I guess. I'm just gonna apply this on the inner part of my lid and work it in there. And I like to do both eyes at once rather than one eye at a time. So you'll see me bounce back and forth between the two. There is the pink. Very simple, straightforward. Now moving on to the purple, I'm taking a different brush and dipping into that Gumdrop purple shade right here. And I'm just gonna focus that on the, ooh, that's a lot of fallout. I'm just gonna focus that on the middle of the eye. Like so. And blending it into the pink. So there is the pink and the purple. Now you could stop here, you could just do pink and purple, but I'm gonna take it up a notch and I'm gonna use blue as well. So yet another brush, and I'm gonna dip into Brain Freeze, which is this light blue shade right here. And I'm gonna finish that on the outer portion here. Okay, so once I have the colors down as a base, I'm gonna take a blending brush with no product on it, and I'm gonna go through and just kind of go along the top edge of the shadow and just blend them all together like that. Then once they're all blended together, I'm actually gonna go in and pack the colors on a little bit so they're more vibrant. As you can see, the top is done. Now I'm gonna mimic the same thing along the bottom, but before I do that, I'm gonna line my waterline with a pencil, and this is the NYX Faux Whites pencil, and this one is in the shade White Smoke, but it's actually a really light pale lavender color or a lilac color. So I'm gonna go ahead and line my lower waterline. Like I said, I'm gonna mimic the same colors that I used on the top on the lower lash line. I'm gonna take a very narrow tapered brush so I can really focus the product each individually on. I am gonna use the same brush for each of these, so I'm gonna work lightest to what I think is darkest. So the pink, I'm gonna focus on the inner corner. So there is the pink, and now I'll give my brush a little swirl just to kind of clean the pink off, and then moving on to the purple. Give my brush a swirl, and then doing the blue. Okay, so now that it's done, I'm going to go ahead and cut my crease. And to create my cut crease, I'm literally just going to go in with a liquid lipstick. This one is from the Shane Dawson Jeffree Star collection. Rewind back to what we talked about prior. Just because you bought a product and you no longer support someone doesn't mean you should just throw it in the garbage. You should use the product to the utmost ability that you can and get the full use out of it rather than just completely waste it. So, this is in the shade Ryland, and I have been absolutely loving since I purchased this. I'm going to be blunt and honest with you guys. I've absolutely loved using this on my lids. So I'm going to go ahead and take a flat brush like this one right here, and I'm going to pick up some of the product off of the applicator, and I'm just going to go in and start packing this on, start tapping it on, and it's going to, look at that, it like instantly makes a really pretty shimmery color for our cut crease. And the cool thing about this is you don't have to use a concealer or anything underneath of it. The liquid lipstick itself acts as that, acts as the liquid, and it just eliminates and covers the shadow underneath of it. There that is. You can see it on both sides. I'm gonna give that a minute to kind of dry and set in place without creasing my lids too much, and then I'm gonna move on to mascara. Okay, so at this point, if you're skilled with winged liner, I would do a wing, but I don't got the patience for that today. So if you wanted to take your look up an extra notch, add a black wing. But yeah, I'm just gonna throw on some mascara and some lashes and call that good for the eyes. So I'm just gonna curl these puppies just slightly. Shout out to this amazing little lash curler that I got from Dollar Tree. And the mascara I'm using today is from the brand Essence. This is the Lash Princess. This is the green one. In my opinion, this is the best. This is one of my favorite mascaras of all time. It's super affordable, and I just love how it looks and how it just like defines everything so kind of effortlessly, honestly. Damn, the difference some mascara makes is beyond wild. Especially if you're someone like me who naturally has blonde lashes. All right, I suck at applying false lashes on camera, so I'm gonna do that off camera and I will be right back. Ta-da! A look really seriously comes together after lashes are added. It's insane the difference that can be made. So anyway, yes, here are the eyes finished. Now we're gonna go ahead and do lips and we will be done. So the two products I'm going in with today are the Maybelline Superstay Matte Ink in the shade Dreamer. Number 10 is just a really, really pretty pinky mauve. And then I'm gonna top it off with Candy Drip, the gloss by Jeffree Star. All right, so that is it for my face. I hope you all enjoyed this. Like I said, I wanted to do something that was kind of simple to follow. Y'all had been wanting a makeup tutorial for quite some time, and I wanted to do something that was easy, but that you guys could kind of tweak to make your own style. You can replace the colors with whatever colors you want. You can also replace the colors with a neutral palette and have a more neutral shade. So do like a lighter color, a more mid-tone, maybe mauve-y brown, and then a deeper brown or mauve on the outside and have kind of like that neutral smoky look. So yeah, it's definitely a versatile look. You don't have to follow my steps step by step, but you guys have been requesting a makeup tutorial, so here I am. And with that being said, I hope you all enjoyed this. Don't forget to check out Dossier once again. I love their perfume so much, and like I said, just working with them has been an absolute joy. So with that being said, I'm gonna go ahead and go. I hope you all enjoyed this video, and I will talk to you all next time. So until then, so long, stay strong, stay true, and be you. Bye.
Bye.